Tis the season to be jolly.
La 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 la.
Don we now our gay apparel.
La 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 la.
And now this one. Troll the ancient yuletide carol. You know, it still seems like something's missing. It's not the well-lit Christmas tree. It's not the divinity that's back there on the table for you. It's not hearing the Christmas songs. We've done that. I've blown my budget for Christmas presents, yeah. I've even decorated the outdoors. I've kept busy pursuing the perfect present. I've baked Christmas cookies. I've run to and fro to the Christmas parade and Christmas concerts. I've even watched Christmas specials on TV. But yet, something's missing. The third week of Advent is about love. Love, not hate. Love, not fear. I have a problem with love because I don't know what it really is. I know love isn't what I see on TV or in the movies or what I hear in music. In The 12 Powers of Man, Charles Fillmore gave examples of human love. And if we use these examples, we can open our minds to discover divine love. From Christian Healy, Fillmore says, love in divine mind is the idea of universal unity. In expression, love is the power that joins and binds in divine harmony, the universe and everything in it. 2,000 years after the birth of Christ, we have on earth what we have on earth. Each Christmas, a door or a vortex opens, and the human heart moves into hope, joy, peace, faith, and even love. And shortly after Christmas, I move out of all of those divine spiritual gifts. In my search for spirituality, I heard about unconditional love. I knew and know that human love is not unconditional love. I can think of two examples of unconditional love. Pet love, given and received. And the other is the joy and the hope and the love of a newborn babe. Aunts, uncles, and cousins all rejoice at that newborn babe. Parents and grandparents hold the babe and feel. They feel that love. It is like Charles Fillmore said in The 12 Powers of Man, before the love of God, which is the supreme thing, before the love of God can fill the heart, there must be sacrifice of human love. Much of what we do during the Christmas season is human love. Thus, something's missing. When we renounce human love, maybe we can find divine love. Christmas is about giving, receiving, but I'm not talking about commercialism. Charles Fillmore used the story of Abraham being willing to sacrifice his beloved son Isaac. The story illustrates that we are giving up our personal attachments before we receive the universal realm of divine ideas or spiritual gifts, i.e., divine love. For me, I had to sacrifice self-hatred and its close cousin, negativity thought. You think how strange that one wouldn't be willing to give up self-hatred and negative thought. When we don't know our habits, our destructive thoughts, we hang on to them for dear life. Because negative is what we do know. Negativity is what we're comfortable with. So I had to take that mirror and look in the mirror and say, I love you. Well, that didn't do a whole lot for me. So then I had to take the mirror and look into my own eyes in that mirror and say, I love you. And even though I knew I was faking it with repetition, with the declaration of I love you, it began to become a reality. It did take time for me to move out of my ego self-appreciation and self-protection. Those are two things that I think are human love. And once we move out of the ego, we have become a part of divine directed love. So I ask you, can you look in the mirror and say, I love you? Can you look into your own eyes deeply and know you're not lying to yourself? If you can, you've completed Divine Love 101. I affirm I abandon fear and attachment to demonstrate self-love and a higher vibration. How many of you received punishment when you were a child? And maybe when you got that punishment, you heard the words, I'm doing this because I love you? The incongruent words and actions create a crisscross connection in your mind. At least it did in mine. Love crisscrossed with an action that is not. No wonder we're confused when it comes to love. The human love is so much less than spirit. Mother, Father, God sent a son. So we could learn to find love. Did your parents or grandparents demonstrate unconditional love? Mine didn't. My parents were concentrating on stretching the dollar so that there was enough food on the table every week. It took me a long time to be able to step into a forgiveness piece and give my parents a break for not being able to explore, discover, unconditional love. From Keep a True Lamp, and this quote is in your program, the loves and hate of mind are precipitated into this game reality receptacle of thought and crystallized there. Meaning all love, all thoughts, love and hate, are stored in mind. Fillmore continues, when we even faintly realize the love of God, we begin to love our fellow man. Love is the divine ordinance or decree, and those who let the love of God pour itself out in charity do truly cover and forgive sins, a multitude of sins, both our own and this is the part I'm really. Love pours out its all over every wound, and substance of its sympathy infuses hope and faith into the discouraged heart. Divine love has a balm for every ill. I ask you, is the divine decree of love beyond our comprehension? I think not. During the Christmas season, we see charity and we see kindness and loving acts for mankind. When the door or vortex is opened, divine love waltzes into our hearts, minds, emotions, souls, and becomes an expression on earth. I affirm, as a creator, I choose the expansive vibration of divine providence in me and in my life. Neil Donald Walsh recently released his fourth book in the Conversations with God series, and its title is Awaken the Species. In it, God says, if it is your desire to demonstrate who you really are, the one way you can see yourself doing it is by assisting in ending the suffering of others, bringing healing to a planet, and affecting, in a positive way, the future of those you love. Then you will not feel burdened by an assignment too big, but rather joyously thrilled about the opportunity life has placed before you in this perfect time to advance. I believe that every Christmas is a perfect time to advance. We just have to decide how we want to advance. Recently, K-State let kids out of school for the afternoon, out of their classes, and they had a march, and they held a meeting on the lawn of Anderson Lawn. And what precipitated that was the idea that there was racial bias on campus. I believe through divine love, we can assist in bringing the suffering to an end. We can bring healing, and we can affect a positive future in the students of K-State. I affirm through divine love, it is a perfect time to advance, to joyously infuse Manhattan with what is mine to do, and demonstrate who I really am. In the book, God goes on and says, the basic instinct of humanity is the expression of every human's true identity, which is divinity. Pure love knows no condition and expresses itself at any cost. Pure love knows no condition and expresses at any cost. God continues, that is the fundamental impulse, which is why humans run into a burning building to save a crying baby. We each have a basic instinct to express divinity by becoming the personification of unconditional love. We are following the soul impulse. Now remember, God said that we are following the soul impulse. Neil Donald Walsh says to God, if humans follow the impulse in every moment, they would create heaven on earth overnight. We could do this by simply seeing every minute of every day as a burning building moment. A moment when we do, in fact, easily and instantly access the better natures, the better angels of our natures. I choose an illumined mind, a compassionate soul, and an expansive heart to access my nature, my angel nature, and harmonize my vibration into the God realm. In the past week, the mayor of San Francisco died in the grocery store. One media outlet quoted Ed Lee, and it was his comments of August 18th of this year. This weekend, the people of San Francisco peacefully united to reject hate and violence, and as all politicians do. I want to thank the residents, the community groups, the activists, the board of supervisors, and all San Franciscans that led and participated in peaceful gatherings and marches. Throughout our city, the theme of love and compassion loudly dominated the rhetoric of hate and violence. You know, I do believe I would like for my love race to be something similarly beautiful, creating change. Every year, Unity pulls together a Christmas publication, and this year it's entitled The Light and Love of Christmas. It says, the Advent season often brings out the best in people. The coming of Christmas provides the opportunity and occasion to show up as who we truly are, spiritual beings having a human experience. Who knows that we are one? Now you may look at this and think, no way am I one with this. But I assure you, the spark of divinity that was within you is the same spark of divinity that is within me. And we are one. Christmas is the season when our feelings are forward and we access and spread joy, peace, hope, and even love. I affirm I am truly blessed by the divine love of the season, catapulting my self-love vibration into the world, and the world rejoices for each moment I successfully stay in the vibration of divine love. I ask you this Christmas season and in the new year to make a choice. Make a choice to express divine love. Focus on it daily, and then make it up as you go along. Shouldn't you enjoy the journey on your way to expressing divine love? For me, I've made plans and God laughed. Because providence devises far more creative solutions than I ever will. So this Christmas, when divine love comes in, we keep it present throughout the year. We extend elf love